welcome to Wake Up with Dixon.
Stephen, welcome back.
Thank you.
You've been away now for 8 months. It's been 8 months since you've last been here. How does it feel to be back?
Great. It's really nice to be back, actually, and just catch up with everyone and see how the place is changing and how you lot are all growing into this new school. But it's lovely to be back. Really nice.
Brilliant, yeah. You're doing a masterclass. I think it was going to be this morning, but I think we're going to be doing it afterwards. How do you feel about that? Are you excited for that?
It's a bit weird, actually, if I'm honest. A bit weird teaching. I've got my special badge on. I've got my teacher's badge on. But it's slightly weird because it's hard. You always feel as a broadcaster that you're learning as you go. So the idea of teaching anything is a little bit weird. Yeah. But it should be fun, hopefully interesting.
Yeah, it will be fun.
Yeah, it'd be nice. I think you've got a good range of students as well doing it, so it'll be a lot of fun.
Good. I've brought my ruler so I can bang it on the desk and things if they don't listen.
Of course, yeah. So we know you are now on holiday, obviously a very well-deserved break. You know, what sort of things have you been up to?
I've been up north in the Lake District for a couple of weeks because it was my dad's 70th. So I had a sort of big celebration for that. And I came back last weekend and I've been sleeping a lot and doing lots of nice things like that.
Lovely.
Being very lazy.
Oh, of course. Well, but you have to, don't you?
Well, I think so. I think so. And especially in sort of honour of you teenagers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I've been trying to stay in bed till about 11 o'clock and things, which has been really nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, Stephen, let's change this up a bit. We've actually got some pictures of you. And they are interesting pictures that I'd like you to talk about and describe. I think we've got them on the screen here. Please describe this. You know, it's quite a messy incident.
Are you sure that's me?
I'm pretty sure it's you, Stephen. I mean, I don't actually.
Yeah, I think I was about 6 months old, and that was one Cadbury's chocolate finger, which you can see is now devoid of chocolate as I'm eating it. But I appear to have chocolate everywhere else.
It just looks like a finger now, because all the chocolate seems to have been passed onto your face and stuff.
I do try to eat more nicely now.
Okay,
I make a concerted effort. I had a chocolate biscuit, Alfie, didn't I, earlier on?
Stephen, for those
we don't see
know,
any chocolate around the face.
No. So I've improved slightly.
Oh, yeah.
Wasn't I cute, though?
Yeah, very. Oh, yes. Wow.
Yeah. Dishing for compliments.
Yeah, so I think we've actually got another one. Have we got
one
to show? Oh, now this one. This is like a portrait one. You could hold this up in any family home here. Look at that. That's lovely, isn't that?
No.
Very posy.
Seriously, look at it. It looks lovely.
That was a publicity shot from about, I was about 23, 24.
23, 24.
When it was all the rage then, to wear lots of denim.
Denim stuff.
So it was what you call double denim.
I've actually got a double denim top similar to that.
Have you? Well, it's all coming around now.
Yeah, it's all coming around.
But isn't it awful? I look like an aging catalogue model.
It's interesting, to say the least. But you know, it's good. Like I say, you know, you could hang that up on a wall, I guess.
We've got another one.
Do we have another one? Oh, we do. That's lovely, isn't that?
That's not bad,
actually.
That
isn't bad. It's a portrait. You know,
what year were you in then?
Well, that's my prefix tie, so I must have been in, what would it be, year 11?
11, yeah.
No, fifth that's year. It's fifth year to old fellas like me. It was my fifth year. So I'd have been 15 or 16.
Yeah.
Then. Oh, I don't look.
It's quite nice, isn't it? You've got a nice
grin. Do I look much different?
No, you've still got that sort of V-shaped smile.
Have I?
That sort of, it's an interesting.
It's just my
smile.
face seems to have spread slightly and my hair's lost its colour. But, you know, apart from that, it's all good.
It looks quite nice now. I think that's all the pictures there.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for that.
It's fine, pleasure.
So for those of you who don't know, Stephen has a pet cat called Timmy. How has he been, you know, since you've been on your breaks? Has he been pleased you're back?
He's been good. Well, I took him up north with me.
Yeah.
To my mum and dad's house because they love cats. And so that was nice, but he's not allowed out when he's up there.
Okay.
And he likes getting out. Yeah. So he's been, he was getting a bit tetchy after 10 days. So he's glad to be back now.
Yeah.
He's out today. We went out at 6 o'clock this morning. He's going to be out till I get home. So he's getting most of it today.
Well, he's going to have a nice little wander around.
He will. He'll be starving when I get home because he's not had any breakfast. But he'll be all right.
Yeah, he'll be fine. Well, many of our students here are going on the New York trip your New York trip, right. Which we understand you are also going along to.
Yes.
How do you feel about going with such like a wide range of students? You're looking forward to it?
Yeah, I am actually, because I like getting away, but I don't get away very often.
Yeah.
And so I think it's quite nice to get away with a purpose. And so having something to do with all the students will be nice, and all the walking tours that we're doing and all that sort of thing. So it'll be quite busy, which is good. I am slightly worried because Mr. Katanak said that one of the things that you have to do with on school trips is keep everyone very busy all the time, so that they're always busy. So he did say that by the end of 5 days, I would be absolutely exhausted.
Pretty sure all of the others will be as well.
Yeah,
you won't be so, one, Stephen. No.
So I might have to have a holiday at the end of it. Yeah. But I am actually really looking forward to going and spending a fair bit of time with the students who are there.
Yeah,
you know, just to get to know them a bit more.
Yeah, which is really nice. Yeah,
it is nice.
You've got to know the future competition, I think.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Now, but Stephen. Let's change it up a bit. You are a man of many talents, are you not?
Well, I'm not entirely sure.
I'm going to answer that question for you. You are, okay?
Right.
We want to put your talents to the test here.
Right.
Okay? Now, you noticed earlier on, because you whispered in my ear, you said, what's that with the auto cue, okay? On the auto cue, we've got some rather difficult words for you to pronounce. But what we've done is we've put them in a paragraph, as you would usually read off an auto cue.
Right.
And you will have to read it out. It's like a news report, basically. Let's see if you can manage it. It'll be interesting. I did say it'd be interesting to you, Stephen. Remember that?
You did. You know, the newsreader's secret is if you're not sure what the word is, you either miss it out or just say it with a lot of confidence.
Oh, right.
Okay. I think we should go for that one, the second one.
Say it with a lot of confidence. Don't miss it out.
Right.
Okay, are we ready?
A very good morning and welcome to Wake Up with Dixon, your new morning show that's got it all. I'm Stevie Dixon, and no, you're not still dreaming. A very good morning. Our headlines today. Woolly Big Shuggy from Kealarrick in court today for cruelty to his sheep flock on his croft near Achtermuchty. Tam Diabolik from Elsie Felshen near Kirkcudbright wins a prize for the biggest cucumber in the Mahago Summer Fete. And Fatty McButterpants, lorry driver from Killintock near Glasgow, tells us the benefits of his new sat-nav. But breaking news from our Royal Correspondent, Bay Worley, who's interviewing Mr. Wayne Kerr, Royal Correspondent from the Daily Chronicle, live from Drick-on-Tweed. Oh dear. Tell me, Wayne.
Come on, Stephen, come on.
How is Tavish McHaggish, the new son of the prince? Is it a boy or a girl? It's a boy? Bay? Oh, I see. Why is that? Well, we interrupt this royal breaking news for some more breaking news, and over to Claude Screcham and Lord Longrod McHugendong from Loch Goylfed. Oh, this is cruel. Very good morning, everyone. More breaking news now. Blah, blah, blah,
blah, blah. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm going to give you a round
of applause. That was very actually, that was quite
that
good.
That was decent.
You know,
that was pretty good, I'll give you that.
That was
one.
Quite good.
Fair enough, Steve. Oh, that was interesting.
That was a bit rude.
Oh, no.
Just, you know,
just a little bit.
He kept it PG there. There is absolutely nothing wrong with that. Don't you worry, Steve.
They're not going to be right, though, are they? I went for it.
Yeah.
I went for it.
Pointless.
Fair enough. Well, so we've seen you on that challenge. We now have another one for you. This is all about trying to get the correct answer to a question I will ask you. There is only one answer, so think wisely.
Right.
So the first question is, who would you like to have a dinner date with?
What do you think?
Well, with all this around, I'd quite like to have a dinner date with the doctor.
The doctor?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Just because that's going to be
quite cool, wouldn't it?
Very interesting.
Okay.
Yeah? Shall we take a look? If you've got the right answer, just turn to the screen.
Oh! I nearly said Gillian.
You got the wrong answer, just to repeat there, Stephen. You did get the wrong answer for that one, unfortunately.
Oh, well, she's
How
a married
do you think
woman.
She
she's a married
oh,
woman.
Me.
So she's probably not. Oh, bless
I understand
her.
That.
Hello, Gillian.
Yeah.
I love Gillian.
Oh, yeah. Thank God she isn't here now. She would have been a bit disappointed with you.
Yeah, she probably would. Yeah. The second question is, who is your favourite broadcaster?
Is it Gillian Joseph?
Let's take a look. Well, You got that one right.
I got that one right.
You should be happy about that.
Right.
Fair play.
Because there is a fair few broadcasters out there. So
there are. There are.
Probably quite happy about that one.
I do know how important my Saturday and Sunday and Friday mornings are with Gillian, and what pain she could put me through if I got that one wrong.
Well, we have heard you have been a little bit cruel to Gillian and Naz recently, you know, with the pictures.
Did you see those pictures?
Did you want to explain yourself? I don't know if we've got them on the screen.
Well, it wasn't me. To be fair, this isn't me. I just tweeted them. This is someone in our graphics or vision mixing department who created it. That's the Eurovision winner from a couple of years ago. And then the one of Gillian is Gillian merged with one of our reporters, Ashish Joshi.
Yeah.
So it wasn't me. I just took the pictures and tweeted them.
You just thought, you know, put them out for everyone to see.
I did ask Gillian's permission for that one. Isn't it cracking?
We will take your word for
that. It is very funny.
But bear in mind, that's a, like, 40-foot-high news wall.
Jeez.
So it was... That's a great shot. It's a great shot.
Now, Stephen, we're looking to keep you on your tiptoes here. What other talents do you possess, do you feel? Do you possess any other talents?
Not really.
Well, how about singing?
Oh, no.
Now, Stephen, come
on. Oh, no.
Okay.
Where did you get that from?
Well, this is where we've got it from. I think we've got a bit of proof here for you, Stephen.
Is it your second from the right at the top, is it?
That's me, yeah.
We have done research, Stephen, you see. Is that Songs of Praise?
We know our stuff.
Songs of Praise how old were I? I'd have been about 10 or 11. That was at primary school, so about 1984 or something like that, or 83.
Okay, well, we want to put this to the test.
You want to, you know,
Stephen,
just really see if you're still with it.
I can see you panicking, but don't you fret, okay? Because I will be with you singing, okay?
Oh, God, you're not serious.
Well, that's why the glitter ball is.
Oh, no.
Did you not see the glitter ball?
Can you kind of guess a song that might be going on? You know, very well known recently, Disney.
Not Frozen.
Well, Stephen.
Got it, straight
I
away.
Think it's about that time, Stephen. Come on, Stephen.
I only know the.
Stephen, I'll do the solos if you can't manage it. But, you know, come on, let's come
do
on.
Do we get words?
Oh, no.
They'll be up on the screen.
It's coming up.
Oh, they'll be up on the screen.
If you can still see
them, that is. And we came well prepared, Stephen.
Is it coming on the screen? We haven't. Oh, here we go.
Snow glows white on the mountain. Not a footprint to be seen.
A kingdom of isolation. And it looks like I'm the queen. So, next bit.
Wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. You're not helping with the tune, really, out
there.
You've got
the others.
Well, I was in the choir, so
heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in.
Don't let...
I can't do it on my own.
See?
Come on. Be the good girl who always had to be.
Conceal. Don't feel. Don't let them know.
I'm not even looking at the screen here. So, come on.
Well, now they know.
Let it go.
Let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go. Let it go. I'll see your crappy.
Turn away and slam the door.
I don't care what they're going to say.
Let the storm rage on.
The cold never bothered me anyway.
Oh, lovely.
Should we do X Factor?
I think we should have some distance.
You know, you might have a bit of trouble with Simon, but I think you'll be all right.
Yeah. I think we're doing well here.
And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all.
I got that note.
It's time to see what I can do. Test the limits
and break through,
Alfie.
No right, no wrong, no rules for me.
I know that.
I'm free.
Let it go, let it go. I am the one with wind and sky. Use let it go, let it go. You'll never see me cry. Here I stand, and here I'll stay. Let the storm rage on.
I think that's a little bit where she builds the castle. have a look at what she's doing.
I've never seen a film.
My power flurries through the air into the ground. My soul is swirling in frozen fractures, concentrate all around. My one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. I'm never going back, but the past is in the past. Let it go, let it go, and I'll rise like a break of dawn. Let it go, let it go, that perfect girl is gone. Stand in the light of day. Oh, day. Storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway.
Give a round of applause for Stephen Dixon there.
Woo-hoo!
I'll tell you, man. Don't worry about that. That was lovely.
That
you
was
take
very
a seat.
Good.
I'm sort of shell shocked a little bit.
Don't worry, Stephen.
I was really getting that songs of praise choir through there. Very nice.
Look, can you tell I'm sweating there?
That's awful. Don't worry, I'm just as much as embarrassed as you.
Now we do have a little surprise for you. We do have a link on Skype at the moment. Should be coming up if you look at the screen. I don't know if we've got it complete. Here we go. We've got Reed here with us.
Reed, how are you?
Oh, we
we've
can't.
Got, we've got no sound.
Reed, I can see you, but I can't hear you.
Have we got a,
do you know what? Live TV wouldn't be live TV without technical issues.
No, of there
not.
We go.
Of course not.
Oh. Can we? I think we may.
Hey!
That is great news. I'm so relieved right now. That was very stressful.
You're telling me.
So, Reed, how do you... How
well,
do you
first
see?
Of all, let me just say there's a bit of a delay, but I'm really delighted to be here. Stephen, congrats on a great year with the Bath Studio School. Of course, I've been following along from this side of the pond, and I know how thrilled everyone there is to have you and vice versa. So I'm very excited to be here now that a year has gone by. And I've got a question for you. I know you guys have questions for me, but Stephen, has it gone by quickly? Is it crazy to think about?
Oh, yeah, it absolutely flies by. It flies by. But I tell you, it's so nice to be back here and to see how everyone's progressing and improving. It's really exciting stuff. You're going to have to come here, Reed, at some point.
I love it. I'll have to take you up on that. Absolutely. But I know you guys have some questions for me. So now that we've got the audio back online, I'll let you fire away.
So how do you guys actually know each other?
Oh, this is a cool story. Okay, well, first of all, it's all down to Stephen because he's really, really awesome. And how many people would be as warm and friendly as he is, particularly over social media? So we have Twitter to thank. Stephen, I remember, this must have been about 2 years ago now, and I was just leaving. This is very apropos, since anybody who knows me knows that I'm a major Anglophile at heart. I was leaving afternoon tea, and I think my book, it must have been about June, was just underway and in the publishing and editing process, and I was with my editor, and a message came across on my iPhone saying new follower on Twitter, and of course, lo and behold, it was at Stephen Dixon TV, which was so crazy, and I think I had followed you maybe a couple days before that same day because I'm such a big fan and I've seen you on Sky News many times during my visits to the UK. And then, you know, we just, I think, sent back a couple quick messages saying, you know, great to meet you over Twitter. And I know that your family, your niece and nephew, I think, are fans of Nickelodeon, which is a very big compliment indeed. And then a couple months went by and we stayed in touch. And then last year, you very generously invited me onto Sunrise, which was so cool. And the rest is history. We've stayed great friends ever since. Do I have all my facts right? Is that correct?
You do, but you see, Reed is too kind and too humble, really, because he was over in the UK, and I said, look, do me a favour, come on the show, talk about healthcare stuff and let's plug the book. And he just did it and was just such a brilliant guest and it's fantastic.
That's really lovely. Brilliant. It's really nice that you've actually stayed in touch though as well.
Oh yeah, and well, Reed is just one of the nicest people in the world and he's so generous. with what he does and what he says, and he sent messages to my niece and all sorts of lovely things. So it's I owe you a big thanks, Reed.
Oh, please. You're awesome, Stephen, and the feeling is totally mutual. Thank you. Yeah, no, this is fun stuff. It's crazy, by the way, that I don't know if we've really discussed on air before that, you know, we met over Twitter. It's crazy how many friends you meet on social media, but how fun, and I think it's very appropriate that now we're having this conversation over Skype.
Yeah, it's brilliant, and it's a real surprise to me. It's really good to have you here.
So we've got another question here. What sort of things are you up to at the moment?
Oh, some great stuff. Okay, I got it there. I'm working on another cookbook right now, and let's see, I'm working on a very exciting new show that I can't say a lot about, but it's back in the acting space. So between those two, I'm, you know, keeping pretty busy. And I shared with Stephen, actually, who was incredibly supportive of this, a new project of mine that I haven't quite announced. But it's very exciting. You know, of course, my roots are really in entertainment, but it's a bit of a foray, I guess, into like the media journalism business world. And I'm studying. I'm going to NYU, just like you guys are students right now, which is really awesome. So I think between the two presenters here and myself, we've got a lot in common. This is a very international collegiate environment. I'm studying broadcast journalism, in fact, and I'm really enjoying it. So very fun to now get a peek inside this TV studio, which is ultra professional. I wish we had that here at NYU. What a shame.
Yeah, no,
yeah, it's a lot of fun, isn't it?
Lovely place. Yeah, we've actually got another question for you, Bree. Stephen's promised to take, because all of the students here are going to New York. Soon, and Stephen's promised to take us all out for a slap-up meal. Where you have, Stephen, you know you have. Now, what would you recommend? What would be a nice restaurant in New York City?
What would be a nice restaurant? There are so many. Okay, let me think. Any food preferences? Does everybody want to weigh in here? Everyone's favorite food?
Just
that'll
anything.
Help me.
Anything. Seriously, anything.
Italian. What about Italian?
Anything. Oh, my gosh.
I like a bit.
All right, my favorite restaurant that I think you've got to check out if you're downtown and you're really into like Asian food, this is super fun. It's one of those like New York places that's really cool and great music, great vibe. And I just like to say the name. It's called Budokan. So write that down.
Budokan.
That's a fun place. And then if you want Italian and you're on the other side of town, closer to uptown, in fact, in my neck of the woods, I'd say to check out a place called Lavo, L-A-V-O. So those are my restaurant recommendations. I like love living here mainly because of the food. Forget everything else. It's just like an edible city. There's a lot of good stuff to eat. But I think the best thing about New York, and that I'm sure you'll find when you come here, is that you walk down any street, very much like London, and there are a million places on every street corner that are really fun to check out. So you'll be surprised what you come across.
Will you join us for dinner, Reed?
Absolutely. I'd be delighted. It would be a great honor, of course. So plan on it. Pick your favorite place. Who cares about my list? Do a lot of yelping and trip advisoring and all that good stuff, and I will totally be there. It would be a great pleasure.
Fabulous.
That's lovely. Well, it's been great to talk to you. I'm sure we'll talk to you again soon.
Thank you so much for inviting me. Really great to be here. And again, Stephen, big congrats, and to everyone at the school on a great year. Talk to you later, you guys.
Bye.
Great to see you, Reed.
Bye.
Bye.
Of all the, when you meet people in show business, of whatever type, and often, you know, child stars often turn out to be very, very precocious people.
Yeah.
And Reed is the most down-to-earth, nicest and humblest and most generous person you will ever meet.
He seems so lovely.
He is really, and if he says he'll meet us for dinner in New York, then he absolutely will. He's really lovely. What a treat.
He is, he's a nice chap. So, Stephen, we have heard rumours. I know, it's been
go on.
Bit of an event so far, and we've only something like 20 minutes into it already, but...
I wish it's not been about 4 hours.
Unfortunately it hasn't, but we've heard you're into a bit of Strictly.
Oh, no.
You know, we thought, you know, because you wanted to go on Strictly, you know...
Yeah. I got emailed by Strictly once, saying that, or they wrote me a letter saying, just to advise you that people have been contacting us asking you to be put forward. and then that was it. I didn't reply to
Why
it.
Why didn't you reply to
well,
it?
Because it wasn't saying...
There's an opportunity list there. What
it wasn't. They weren't saying we want you to be on it. They were just saying people are writing in telling us they want you to be on it.
Maybe if you replied and you were like, you know, I'd really enjoy that. I'd really like to do that. They might have... on the extra step?
Maybe. I think I've probably got two left feet.
I very much doubt that. Well, actually, funnily enough, we're about to find out.
To put it to the test?
Yes, I think it is about that time for a bit of a dance. What do you think?
Oh, God.
Don't you worry.
What sort of dance?
Now, here we go.
Well, we have special guest Dylan, don't we?
Dylan is actually about to come on and... strut his stuff for us. He's coming on here.
Hello, Dylan.
Oh, yeah.
Ma, you look nice.
He's a lovely frock.
He's looking rather
fetching. Like a strictly frock.
But what we're going to do, me and Dylan are going to show you some moves.
Right.
Okay?
What, then I've got to do a routine.
And then you will, okay? But we'll explain that all afterwards. We'll show you what you're going
to
do afterwards.
Right.
We'll just strut our stuff first.
You keep pulling that dress down, Dylan.
Don't worry, we got this. Isn't it just lovely?
It's smashing.
It's pretty. So, are you ready? Okay, dance routine here.
Oh no.
Got it all together.
Oh no. Alfie's enjoying it a bit too much.
Yeah, he is.
Now,
that was really
can I just explain to everybody what that catastrophe just was? Okay, we had done this morning, okay?
That's excellent.
In the time space, Stephen.
I thought it was very good.
I thought it was pretty decent, wouldn't you say?
It was quite good, yeah.
You know, choreography was done by none other than Dylan. You know, so I think Dylan deserves a round of applause for that.
I think Dylan deserves a round of applause for being quite that.
It was pretty impressive. Now,
quite that brave, to be honest.
Stephen, I've got a hair in my mouth. I do apologise.
No, that's all right.
Stephen, I think it's one of mine. Now, Stephen, if you would be so kind as to come up, and we will show you some dance moves. I'm sure you're. You know, you're yearning to do.
Okay.
Then we're going to blindfold you. Okay.
Oh, God.
Okay. I know we want to go above and beyond. Okay. So we will show you, you know, a few moves.
All right.
Okay. That you could do with your partner. So first things first.
Partner.
Should we do the boogie? Okay.
Yep.
The boogie. So that's literally one step to the side.
Yeah. The opposing way to your partner.
Yeah.
Right.
That sort of thing. That's what we're doing.
So I don't know which way my partner's going to be going, do I?
You do that, you know, five times if you can.
Five.
That's what we need dinner time.
One, two, three, four,
it doesn't have to be perfect. You know, just have a bit of a boogie. Just do the moves. That's the most crucial thing. The next one is the slide.
Yeah.
I call it the penguin slide, personally.
Yeah, I can see why.
So a sort of, like a little, you know. Dylan puts a bit of sass into it, but that...
Dylan's got a bit of sass in that.
Know, does a bit of a booty wiggle as well, you know, is necessary at some points, okay? Now, the next one is, I believe it was a shimmy, wasn't
it? Yeah.
The shimmy. Now, the shimmy, I actually did it wrong, to be honest.
Did you?
I was meant to go... I was meant to go back.
Oh!
And then go like that, okay? But you know, 5 minutes...
Well, look, it looked fine.
It looked okay, I think.
No one knew you made the mistake, so it's fine.
Oh, exactly. Yeah. Stephen didn't even know.
I didn't know.
I know, it's brilliant. So the next move is actually my personal favourite, okay? Is where we do a bit of a walk, like this.
Yeah.
And at a simple nod of your partner, okay? We turn the opposite way, like that, if you will, okay? That's the sort of dance move that, you know, that's my favourite one. I'm not sure what you call that. I call it the semicircle slide, to be fair for me. But you can call it whatever you want, as it will. Is that it? And then, if you will, you will bow at the end.
Bow.
You
know.
I forgot the spin.
The spin! How could we forget the spin? So the spin is, you spin him, okay? So you go like
that,
okay? And I did a cheeky spin like that just because...
Why you not? Could.
Because I could, exactly.
Right.
Now, what we're going to do here...
You keep pulling that down, Dylan. It's could be a bit dangerous, if you know what I mean.
A bit of dignity for him. Yeah. You know, we're going to keep being. So what we're going to do now, Stephen, we're going to blindfold you. I do believe I have the blindfold on me. Don't you worry. I've got it here. Stephen, now, this is a nice fabric blindfold. It will be comfortable
right.
on your head. I know, you know, you know, all that pizzazz and stuff, you know, as a news reporter, you know, just you want to have the best quality.
I do, just don't
you want to put it on yourself, or do you need, you know?
I just don't want to pull the wig off.
Yeah. Oh, you went, I know. We all know there's a wig on stairs, don't you? Okay, can you see anything?
No.
Okay, you can't. Let me just double check for you. There we go. Okay, how many fingers am I holding up?
No idea.
Okay, now, we've got... You won't know who you're dancing with.
Oh, am I dancing with Dylan?
Might be, but I think you're going to be dancing with someone else as well. Right. Might be dancing with Dylan, you might be dancing with someone else.
Right.
Okay? They are coming on just here.
Are they going to lead me with someone?
They are going to lead you. Now, you can have... I think... I'm not sure if it's the same song. I think it's a different song. But you will be dancing with this lovely person here. If you would step a bit closer, Dylan. Just a bit closer, and then
right.
One closer. There you go. And I will leave you guys to
Are you going
to
remind me of what moves I'm meant to be doing?
The suit... Oh, your suit. I'm sorry, Stephen. Your suit was messing up a bit there.
Sorry.
Now, if you guys might have... We will play some music for you, and we can have a bit of a boogie-woogie, OK? Just any dance moves. Just lead your partner. This is a deep and passionate song. So deep and passionate moves will be required.
This
here.
Is weird. Is okay? This legal?
I don't know. Guys, go on.
OK, are we
now,
ready?
Play the music, if we will.
I don't...
Just go with it, guys. Just go with it. Here we go, Stephen. Gone. Okay, the boogie. The boogie first.
It's just
okay. This is a nice boogie. Okay, now in a bit, do a slide. The slide. Remember the slide? Penguin slide? That's it, the penguin slide. Your partner is doing exactly the same as you.
Are you sure?
Brilliant. Yes. Okay. Now if you will, you will do a shimmy. Shimmy. You remember the
Back
shimmy.
Back first,
don't you?
Remember?
Back first. There you go, that's it. We're doing well there, Stephen. That is brilliant, okay? Now afterwards, you will do the semicircle slide. Here comes the semicircle slide. Grab your partner and go one way, you know, with the circle. That's it. Yeah, that's it, okay. Now, go the other way, guys. This is meant to be an elegant dance here, okay? There we go. Now, if you will spin your partner, Stephen, there you go. And I think you guys can take a bow now. You've done a tremendous job. Now, Stephen, if you will take off your blindfold.
Do you know what is weird?
Yes.
This feels like Gillian.
That's what it is. Oh, dearie me.
You touched me. No.
This is a lovely moment. This is a lovely moment.
I'm going to touch you. Oh.
How are you?
Give them a moment, guys.
No.
Now, Gillian, come sit down.
Come and take
down.
A seat.
It does, it just felt like you.
Come sit
I
down.
I thought he's going to know my perfume.
Hello.
I've been watching you. You've done really well.
It's done all
Do you
right.
like my singing? She loves my singing, does she?
Did you see the singing, Gillian?
It's better in the studio.
Oh, it's better.
He's usually a bit higher.
Yeah, I know, I'm sorry.
Came down and not
Let it go.
We couldn't get the right notes,
Let
could we?
Go.
Gillian, I must ask, what is he really like? What is he really like?
I see you being here.
I don't want him to listen, but he's absolutely a delight to work with. And it's not like work when we're together.
Yeah.
It's just fun.
Yes.
Fun.
Yeah, turn your phone off, Alfie. That's all I'm saying.
That's not what, I don't know where that came from, actually. I think it came from behind me. Someone's left their phone behind here. I don't know where that was. Now, yes.
So, right. What is the best thing about working with Stephen?
Can I say? Well, it's just fun from start to finish. And I never know what he's going to say. So I'm always thinking, well, he's always embarrassing me on air the whole time. Because we have these private conversations in the break, and then he tells everyone when we're back on air, all the time.
I do.
He lets all my secrets out.
So is that
things
maybe
my husband
not
doesn't
so
even
great.
Know. Don't mention the car.
Don't mention the car, no, or the dents, the numerous dents in the car. You know, this is going on YouTube for everyone to see.
Yes, it will be there. Your singing will be there forever.
Oh, and our dancing.
For eternity there, Stephen.
It's quite good.
We might be fired after this.
3, 4, 5 times.
It is possible.
So who's this?
This is you.
This is me?
Yes, it is.
What's probably not so great about your job? Not to get you in trouble or anything?
Or the hours. Or getting up.
Yes, getting up at 3 is not so great, and it never gets any easier.
No.
I've been doing it for a number of years, and every time that alarm clock goes off at 3 a.m., you think, oh, really? Again? But once you're up, showered and out, it's fine. But it's the getting up is always...
Getting up is a bit of a tricky...
Bit difficult. Yeah.
Now, a question that I'm sure relates back to a lot of the people here. What do you think is required to be successful in a media role, do you think? Your personal views on it. What do you think is crucial to be successful in a media role, do you think? Any media role.
I think a great amount of tenacity, willingness to kind of just get stuck in. Yeah. You know, you can't quibble about the hours, you can't quibble about being tired. You've really just got to jump in with both feet and get on with it, really. There's no room for moaners in this industry. Just be prepared to work really hard.
No, I think that's fair enough. Now, Gillian. I bet you want to get your revenge on Stephen after the cruel pranks he's made, okay, on you, hence the beard pictures that we just showed. I know, I imagine...
You had a shave today, which is nice.
How dare he? How dare he, Gillian? That's not very nice there.
How dare you?
Yes, exactly. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to have a bit of a bake-off. And I sense Stephen understood that when he saw the
I did see a couple of microwaves.
Yes. We're going to... I think we're going to cook a little cupcake, aren't we?
A mug cake, I believe.
Yeah. Should be interesting. I don't know if Gillian... I think Gillian's cooking is a bit like her singing.
Yeah.
My singing's very good.
Gillian with ABBA. Yeah.
We did not know that. We need to do more research in the future.
Oh, you said you'll need to watch Sunrise any weekday morning to hear that mentioned.
Don't worry, we will. I'm sure we will. Now, what's going to happen is...
Should we follow over here and we'll explain when we're over?
Yes.
So, Gillian, if you want to stand on this side and Stephen over on that side.
Right. Oh, look at this.
What will be happening here is obviously you have your ingredients. Mixed together, I suppose.
This is a mug cake, so it's fairly straightforward to make. Have you guys made any sort of cakes before? You know,
Yeah.
Oh, of course.
I make a mean Victoria sponge. I'll have you.
I make a mean Victoria sponge too. We're on point here, Steve.
We are.
Loving that.
We are.
Okay. Now.
This has got diabetic sugar. Is this for you, this one?
We can swap afterwards.
Okay. Oh, we could actually. That's not a bad idea. Aprons. There are aprons just behind you. I appreciate.
Pop those on.
There you go. Stephen, you can have the pink one if you feel so inclined.
Oh, okay. Did I have?
Or maybe not with the pictures on, but never mind.
Please let me win, Reed. Oh, Reed, okay.
I think they look rather fetching, to be honest.
I like mine.
They've done a good job. Actually, I think that looks very nice.
I need to see you and at some point as well, you and Barnett, to talk about flying stories. Because he's been flying, hasn't he? He's an RAF cadet. See, I keep a track on all of you guys and what you're doing.
Okay. Fine, Stephen. Now, guys, this is a challenge, okay? Who can make the best mug cake? Now, Gillian, I'm not going to lie here, Gillian, but this is your time to shine, okay? This is your time to get revenge.
He doesn't have to wear the microphone.
It says this guy here. 85 minutes on mine.
So, you'll mix them all up, pop them in the mug, then you'll use the microwaves behind you. You obviously have one each on your side. You'll pop them in for 7 minutes. And then see what comes out. And then we do have a special judge who will see which one's best.
Oh.
Yeah.
Damn, there's nothing in
it. You haven't actually made your mug cake yet.
Sorry, I was just...
Stephen, sorry about that. Now, bake away, guys. We'll be chatting along with you.
Well, do we just start now, then?
So, Gillian.
Yeah, so whatever you think you need to do first, really.
So, Gillian.
Yeah.
I know we've already asked, but... is there certain stuff that Stephen does that is just genuinely a pain? Is it
he
stuff like that?
He makes rude jokes.
Rude
all
jokes,
the time.
Stephen. Yes. Stephen, explain yourself.
Oh, this now, is Gillian. Now
and then it
Gillian.
Corrects me not to laugh.
Gillian Joseph. Well, the weird thing is, and what makes a good show is not only, and obviously you've got brilliant producers and all the content, but actually getting on, a lot of people in duos don't get on that well.
Really?
And oddly enough, me and Gillian get on. I don't know why.
I like to let him think we get on.
Yeah, but we just, so it's...
There's two sides to this story, I believe. I don't think this is entirely true.
So being sometimes I am a little bit naughty.
You're naughty.
But I can get away with it because we are both in our 40s.
I can understand. Well, may I say, you both don't look...
Well, he normally, when guests come on, he says, oh, doesn't Gillian look good for 79? They're like, really?
really, is she? That's his
standard
joke.
Someone did believe that at one point.
Do they believe
this
it?
Is making me look like a really bad cook,
that's,
this is.
Not great, Stephen.
Well, you've not got the biggest bowl, so not to worry.
Not to worry, guys.
I'm not sure about
make
the measurements.
Make as much mess as you like, hence why you've got your aprons on. You can take these aprons home, I'm sure.
These must be measured out, Gillian, ready.
Really? It's not really how I do
guys
cake
are
normally.
Doing
it. Oh my gosh.
I think it's marvellous.
It's actually four minutes in the microwave, guys. Oh, I was not that long.
I was thinking 8 minutes is quite a lot.
Yeah,
I need a spoon, not a whisk.
See, this is what she's like at work. It's moan, moan, moan. She's never happy.
Well, when you're making jokes like that, Stephen, I wonder why. It's no wonder she's moaning.
She's the only person I know who orders. I don't eat at work, but Gillian eats quite a lot at work. And she's the only person I know who sent back boiled eggs from the canteen because he'd been shelled incorrectly.
Shelled incorrectly.
What does that mean?
They've left bits of the shell on, and it was awful.
Less bits of the shell on. Okay, interesting.
Right.
Stephen.
Hello.
I don't know how this
now,
is going.
What is it like working with Gillian?
Do you know what? In all seriousness, I love it. I absolutely love it because it's no effort.
Yes.
That's the thing,
that's
it's
the
no
main
effort.
Thing.
And we've got it to such a way that because a lot of what we do isn't scripted and a lot of the interviews when I've got people in the studio, obviously we'll both chip in and things, we do a lot just by looking at each other.
Oh, right.
So, you know, yes. I've got a
spoon for you over here.
Oh, thank you.
Extra help.
I'll throw a look at Gillian, or, you know, look back at her, because we're not in the same eye line. And if she wants to come in with a question, she'll give me a nod and all that. And so you just, it just means we segue without crashing into each other. And so that's just nice. It just doesn't take any effort or any thought.
Now, back to the cakes.
Stephen's doing quite well over here, actually.
Well, actually, Stephen's just changed it up there. He, because Gillian went straight in with all the chocolate. She just jumped it all in. But, Stephen, you went for a slightly different approach. You whisked for quite a while.
Well, I mean, it's well known that when it comes to chocolate, Gillian just pop it straight in. I'm a bit more delicate.
Who's had the chocolate biscuit today? Thank you very much.
How do you know about... you were watching earlier.
Oh, yeah, you. Yes.
I have to say, I cannot believe you're here.
I can't. I would not have been here for anybody else, I have to tell you that.
Would you, do you like doing a cookery spot in the Stephen Dixon studio?
I think we should have it on the sunrise set, actually. I'm going to win, obviously.
It'd be an interesting. I think that would be fine. I think that would be all right. Now, these are coming along quite interesting.
Yeah. Is it a race?
No, We will judge you on how quick you can do it, okay?
Oh,
but
okay.
Mainly we will judge you on how it looks and how it tastes. Those are the two crucial things.
What were these?
Hey, what?
What are these ingredients?
Oil and milk, love.
Oh, okay.
Oil and milk. Just pour it all in.
Honestly.
This comes directly from the kitchen. So whatever
work,
he put
one?
In, I imagine, is fair dues.
Microwave.
We've got quite a difficult microwave over here situation going on.
Please select the cooking time. Hold on.
Oh,
he's got it.
Now, Gillian, this cake is looking interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's kind of a syrupy cake.
Well, hopefully it's combined.
It should be fine. I think it'll be fine.
Let's just put it on then.
Yeah, just...
Go on, Gillian.
Just throw it in.
All right.
You should be better at this. You've got three children.
Oh, dear. Stephen.
Your point is?
Enough. You're being silly now, Stephen.
Well, I've got a bit of chocolate on me.
Yeah, that's why. You've eaten one too many chocolate biscuits this morning. That's why you're upset. Come on. Interesting.
Oh, well, we're
Interesting
going for two
approach.
Here.
Interesting.
Well, I don't know. Was it self-raising flour?
I have no idea.
Oh, was it meant to be?
I would imagine so. That's in cakes,
See?
I think.
Experience over
there you
beauty.
Go. See?
Right, now how do I open this? Oh, no.
You just pull it.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
So you should be nowhere without me.
Interesting. I think
it's four minutes,
Gillian. I think it's 4 minutes in there.
I've only put mine in one mug.
That's fine, Stephen, don't you?
Is it?
Yeah, it's fine.
Is it going to explode?
Oh, I can't get it on 4 minutes. How do you get it on 4 minutes? Okay, I've done a minute.
Actually, to be fair, if it explodes, then Gillian's won. Hasn't she?
Is it too late to swap it into two now?
Yes, it's too late.
No, it's too... Oh, Stephen.
No,
How's it looking?
I could just... Oh, it's looking good. I think it might...
Oh, I think it's already turned quite cakey.
Yeah.
It's turned cakey, Stephen. I'd leave it in there. Don't you worry about that. Oh dear.
It has gone quite cakey. That's pretty good.
It's gone quite cakey. You guys have actually done quite well, to be honest. I'm interested to see what Gillian's turnout like.
I love the fact that you're surprised that we've done quite well.
Yes.
We have heard you're not the best cook, yes. To be honest.
Well, actually, he's quite a good cook.
Oh, is he? Really?
Who told you I wasn't a good cook?
I never said that.
Oh, I baked you bread at my house,
yeah,
didn't I?
Yeah, I was very impressed.
Baked bread.
Interesting.
Wow. Yeah.
My father makes a good bread mixture, actually, funnily enough. Interesting stories about that. My dad cooks homemade pizzas, and they are delicious.
Oh,
they're simply divine.
Is that where we're heading tonight?
No, actually, I'm heading there tonight, but in fact, I'm having spaghetti bolognese. I think someone's cupcake is done.
Yeah, we've got 1 minute.
Not cupcake, God. Two completely different things. But yeah, no, he cooks a very nice pizza, to be fair. What dishes do you guys do? What are your signature dishes?
I do a good lasagna.
We've got some napkins for you just there.
Here we go. Yeah, I'd do a decent lasagna, which is all right.
A lasagna, interesting approach.
A nice veggie lasagna.
Ah, right, a lasagna, that's nice.
What about you, Gillian?
All sorts.
Signature dishes, Gillian.
Chicken.
Oxtail.
Jollof rice.
Jollof rice. Oh, I don't know what that is.
Yeah, it's a Nigerian West African rice dish. With their tomatoes. Very nice.
That's very cultural.
Ah, Stephen. One bicky too many, eh?
Well, this is the thing. It's just nice. We have fun. I thought I wasn't going to see you all of June.
I mean, I bet you didn't guess when I spoke to you. Did I speak to you on Tuesday?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, what are you doing this week?
Oh, it's a nice surprise. You and Reed. How's yours getting on, Gillian?
Yeah, they're smelling quite good.
They are smelling quite. Who's going to sample them? Mr. C is in charge.
I'll tell you what, this is actually a good idea, OK? We've got a judge who will look at them and decide whose is the best.
Oh, no.
But me and Anna will taste them.
Could it be Reed?
It could be Reed.
Mine might not look great, but it'll taste wonderful.
But yes, this is the thing. I think me and Anna should taste them.
We'll mix the
Well, Reed knows he's cooking
exactly,
very well.
Exactly, there we go.
Yeah, exactly. So me and Anna will taste them. So don't worry, Gillian. I've got your back here.
OK.
I got it.
We've only got 20 more seconds on this one.
Okay, this is going to be interesting.
I've never seen Stephen Dixon dance.
Have you never seen him dance?
So
no,
that
was interesting.
When I heard it was dance, I was like, he won't do it. He hates it.
He actually got rhythm.
He got some rhythm.
When I was about 15 or 16, I went to a school dance, and I think it was my brother actually called me Aunt Sally, as in being a scarecrow.
Oh wow!
Ah, right. Interesting. Okay.
Oh.
That's
watch it and weep, Gillian.
Oh, fighting talk.
So,
how's yours coming along, Gillian?
Yeah, very nicely.
Lovely.
So I was always scared of dancing because I was laughed at.
It's true. Well, you're very good today.
So will we see you dancing more in the future now that we know you can?
On set. Oh, you mean Newsroom's Got Talent? No, we do this competition thing called, and I always refuse to do it.
You can dance, honestly.
Well, you can sing as well.
We all saw you giving it a bit of a shimmy here, and it was quite spectacular, if truth be told.
Was it?
Yeah, it was.
It was
quite
very good. I was very impressed.
I thought you couldn't dance at all.
You have little faith, that's all I can say.
Right, I've got 10 seconds left.
10 seconds.
Delicious.
I tell you what, the smells are very, very good. They're looking good. It smells
good.
On the smell test, it's very
good. 2, 1, right.
Here we go.
Oh.
How's yours looking?
Disasters.
It's not disasters.
Oh, sorry, Gillian.
Look. Oh, dearie me.
What are all those white bits in yours? That's not right.
No, they're the little added extras.
Oh, perfect colour.
I tell you what. Oh, Gillian's done a good job there, Stephen. There are white lumps in that one.
And a little add-on. Oh, that one sounds nice.
That doesn't look right, though, Gillian, to be fair.
That was my extra.
I think
this is the
all I'm saying, and I don't want to be vulgar, but if you saw that on the pavement, you'd step over it. No, it's true. It's true. It's true. You would.
Yours has got chicken pox. Look at it.
No, that's...
Look at that. What's that?
Wholesome crunchy bits, Gillian.
Wholesome crunchy bits.
Why are they white?
This is interesting. I'll tell you what, guys, if you will take off your aprons, you've both done a magnificent job.
Thank you.
We'll get our adjudicator for the mug cakes, and I'm sure he or she will judge honestly. But me and Anna will taste them, and we will judge harshly.
And yeah, very harsh.
You're in deep trouble, guys.
You got a spoon,
unfortunately. Yes,
yeah, we will.
Me and Anna can use the spoons, don't worry.
So right. If we go back to the sofas, should we take them over with us?
Should we take the good one?
No, take my good one.
Oh, your good one. Yeah, take your good one. Lovely. There we go. Right.
Oh, that definitely looks best, though, Gillian.
Interesting.
Thank you.
Ill. I want to know what these white bits are.
Interesting.
Oh, it's because you didn't mix your flour properly.
Oh, there we go, Stephen. See, right, now, I think we are going to hand this over to our adjudicator. I do believe, how are we going to show... well, let's just give it away here. Reed is adjudicating. He is on the screen just behind you.
Have to zoom there in on there.
There he is. We will have to show him...
Sorry.
How shall we show Reed the...
Shall we take them...
Can you zoom?
To the
should we take the mugs up to the laptop and just?
Oh, is it on the laptop? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Go on then. You...
I'll tell you what. To make this fair,
I feel like as you come closer to this laptop, it's as though you're getting on a plane and all of a sudden flying thousands of miles to New York in that short distance.
Well, that's true. And next time you're coming to the UK, Reed, if you want your ticket. Paying for by me, then you might realise that this is a very nice cupcake there.
Reed, can I just say there's some unsightly white bits in Stephen.
Well done, both of you.
Yeah, but there's only one winner.
Excellent job. You know, so hold on, there's a little bit of a delay, but let me ask you guys, I know you've been through this probably 100 times at this point. Tell me again, would you, and I feel quite guilty judging this because... You know, I prefer to be impartial. I mean, you guys are journalists. You can understand that, right? So tell me again what flavors these are.
These are mine's chocolate. Gillian's
Mine is chocolate chip.
Gillian's is hard to tell, Reed,
okay,
to be
both,
fair.
Okay, so double chocolate and chocolate.
Yeah.
See.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the first one, yours, Stephen, went up to the top, right?
Yes.
And Gillian, so maybe I'm going to say the former, yours, is the souffle, whereas Gillian's is like a molten chocolate lava cake.
Yes. We weren't making souffle.
This is what I'm guessing. This is very hard.
Go on, Reed.
This is my favorite dessert, seriously. All right, well, I know you guys need me to get it over with, so I have to pick one, right?
Yep, that's the right thing to do.
This is brutal. Stephen, you know, I tend to lean more towards the molten chocolate cake in the menu.
There you go.
Yes!
Oh, right.
Jillian, I'm so...
Very wise man.
Round of applause for Jillian there. Well done. Lovely.
Go on, chuck it across.
I'm sorry. I think I'd rather say it's a tie, but I don't think you'll let me get away with saying that.
No, no, we wouldn't.
You did a brilliant job. But Gillian, very well done. And I was so impressed with what a serious cooking segment this was. Let me tell you something. Wake Up with Dixon is getting the big ratings. I can sense it. The number one show.
Let's hope so, Reed.
Yes. Now, I'm sure we should taste these. Let's give them a taste. I think I will take Stephen's. I will taste Stephen's.
Okay.
Good God,
are they
hot.
Quite hot?
Yes.
That is rather spicy on the fingertips. Right, okay.
It's only the taste buds that matter.
Yes. Let's have a look. Stephen, I will be fair, firm but fair. Okay.
We've got quite a good sponge here.
Well, Gillian's looks very, very firm.
This looks very spongy. Here we go.
Is it hot?
Yeah.
It is very hot, actually.
It also looks very dense.
Mine doesn't look dense.
It does.
Oh, Gillian Joseph.
Oh.
Is that delicious, Alfie? I could have it. You could have this recipe for your next book, Reed.
I'm really getting the chocolate through. Very good. I do quite like it.
First
of all, do you want to swap and do a...
Yes, let's swap.
And secondly, yes, send it my way, and everyone at that table will be getting credit.
Oh, you're swapping now,
yeah,
are you?
Yeah, we're doing it. Oh!
Tells you it was dense.
Just pop it in. No, it's not dense.
So unfair. I'm so jealous. I would like a bite of this.
I'm not sure that you would, Reed, to be fair.
Can I just say one thing about both of your mug cakes?
Yeah.
I prefer mine.
They're filling, okay?
Filling.
And I say that because They're very fluffy and very rather difficult to swallow.
I do like it. It's just
tell the truth. Mine was better, wasn't it?
Has a slight better zazz to
it. I think Gillian's has got that better overall sort of. See, I'm taking another bite.
Can I taste a bit, actually?
You can indeed.
And I want to taste yours as well.
Oh, you see, chocolate, and then she's off. She's off.
Right, I'll taste the horrible one first.
Hey, quick work of those eggs, too. I mean, that's like the fastest turnaround time for dessert ever. I think the New York City restaurants could take a page from Stephen Dixon and Gillian Joseph.
I wouldn't hold this up there, Reed.
Mine's so, more chocolatey.
Oh, right, Gillian's is more chocolatey, apparently.
I'm sorry, Steve.
I've lost that one, have I?
You were very close in there.
It was a close match.
No,
but overall, Gillian's won. I think we should give a round of applause to both of them. To both of them. They've done a tremendous job. Yes. A tremendous job to both of you. You've done very well. And Reed, thank you for adjudicating.
Thank
You've been
you
under pressure all of this production.
Of course, you haven't been able to get rid of me this whole time.
We haven't. No, you've been there, just in there, sitting down there. You've been terrific. Thank you ever so much, Reed.
Thanks, Reed.
Bye.
Yes. Thank you so much.
No
worries. Have fun, you guys. Bye-bye.
So now we do have, I believe, a year 10 student who is going to come and present a lovely check.
Okay. Not sure check. What that signal just meant, but...
on the green screen, so we'd like to come over to the green screen with us.
Green screen.
The green screen. Our trusty green screen, where me and Stephen did a lovely sing-along.
Oh, it's Alvy. Hey, Alvy.
It's Alvy. With the fancy bow tie.
And
come on, Alby.
Just in the middle
there.
So he has got a lovely cheque here for you for your charity.
Oh, brilliant.
This Diabetes UK.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Sponsored
I'm
war.
Just going to get a mic for you, Alby. Here we go. I think we've got a mic here for you there.
You get the karaoke mic, Alby.
A karaoke mic. You get a karaoke mic.
Special.
How good is that? Special there, okay. Have you got any words, Alby?
Yeah, basically, Oscar went for a sponsored...
There you go.
Thank you.
No worries,
we went for a sponsored walk to the University of Bath, and we raised £300 for Diabetes UK.
Brilliant.
Oh,
well
nice
done,
that's
everyone. And, and thank you for everything that you do for that.
Round of applause, Alby. Brilliant job.
Brilliant. It's fantastic.
Well done, Alby.
It will go a long way in help actually predominantly helping people who are struggling to come to terms with it, as well as helping research and things. That's brilliant. Thank you so much.
Yeah, well done, Alby.
And it's nice to see you, Alby.
Yeah, that's
after tweeting away.
If anybody wants to take pictures, I think you three would be a nice. The Alby in the middle, I think, is fitting. There you go.
There
you go. Guys, good. If anybody want to take in the studio, anybody wants to take any pictures there. That's a lovely.
How far did you have to walk?
Well, there was a group of people that run, which was including me. We went for.
You went the wrong way, didn't you?
Yeah, it was. We did 11 miles of running non-stop up the biggest hill in Bath.
You see, that's impressive.
It is.
That's impressive.
That's commitment.
Yeah, you did it in a dress.
In another dress.
In a dress.
Not the one he's wearing, a different one.
He's got quite a collection now, hasn't he?
Yeah. Oh, he's done well.
There's a few of the boys here do enjoy doing that, actually. You'd be surprised.
I've heard about some videos, music videos, where you've been.
Toby, you're doing Iggy Azalea.
You take it. No, you take it.
Thanks,
so would you like to come back down
to the sofas for the send off? Yeah, no, that's lovely. Thank you very much, Alby.
Bye.
Bye.
So,
I know that, aren't we?
Thank you guys for coming on. It's
been
really nice to have you. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves.
Oh, I have.
It's been wild and
nice
very
surprises.
Weird.
It's been a pleasure having both of you on. And I'm sure we'll see you both here again. But also, can I thank the cast and crew for operating?
Yeah, brilliant job.
You've done very well.
There you go.
Everyone in the gallery as well.
Everybody in the gallery, another round of applause in the gallery, well done. And also the teachers who organised it,
yes,
I think, is another
well-deserved
round of applause. But yes, as I say, it's been a pleasure having you both here. It's been brilliant. And Stephen, It's been interesting. I did say, see, Gillian, I said at the beginning it would be interesting, and I feel as though we have all delivered, OK? And now I think you both have earned a well-earned cup of tea or a cup of coffee or something like that.
Yeah.
Might even get a chocolate biscuit as well.
Might do. Do you need a Baileys?
It's only allowed one a day. There you go.
Brilliant. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. No worries. It's been fun.